I know. I said I wouldn't do no many that many videos today, but I gotta do this video here. Because again, it's piggybacking off a lot of stuff that I've been talking about lately. And a lot of people been listening to. And I just want everybody to get an understanding of where I'm coming from. Black folks in immigration. Let me ask you all a question. If you support immigration of any kind, that's one thing. But if you support illegal immigration, where we're talking about these people coming into the country looking for a better life, when in reality we the only motherfuckers to come here as slaves. They come over here in the last 12, 13 years looking for a better life, and they got more rights than we have, and we've been here 400 years. We the only people running around this motherfucking country talking about hands up, don't shoot, when these illegals are coming in, and everybody talking about the detention centers that they're in. Well, how many of y'all ever stopped to go see your cousin that's right up there in CCC, which is nothing more than a concentration camp? How many of y'all stopped to even write a letter to your cousin who might have been locked up in one of the many state prisons or satellite camps here in Louisiana? You know what I'm saying? Well, you can't call home in Louisiana because you ain't got the $15 to $20 to put on a phone card. You can't really take a good bath because you ain't got the money on your books to buy a decent bar of soap. How many of y'all call one of your cousins or answer one of their letters? You know what I'm saying? From one of these private prison industries, which is basically in Louisiana, since we got parishes, everything that's ran here is ran by your parish government. So all the facilities in Louisiana, because think about it, Louisiana is the only state that only has one penitentiary. The only penitentiary we have in Louisiana is Angola State Penitentiary. Then you have what's called satellite camps, like DCI, and then go down to your parish jail. But CCC was so corrupt that them niggas Steve Prater them can't even hold state prison or federal prisoners anymore because they looked up fucking up. Man, they got a concentration camp right there on Hearn Avenue, and Negroes running right here talking about illegals need to have more rights. They need better detention facility. Man, fuck that. When you got black folks right here in America, especially in Louisiana, who just recently lost the title of the prison capital of the world, sitting in shit, man. I mean, in facilities where they don't even go outside. I mean, I was down there in Natchitoches. I did a year in Natchitoches. And until I got in work release, man, I probably hadn't went outside in 3 months. You got 80 people sitting in one room. Up at CCC, which is really worse, man, you got 3 people living in a room the size of a bathroom. And black folks are championing illegal immigrants. This is why I do what I do. I try to make you all think about things in a whole different manner than what you've been told on that television. Because if you continue to listen to that television, black folks will be extinct in America within 40 years. Because right now, we've been here for 400, and guess what? Even outside of the Asians, the people, the Polynesians, the people coming from the islands and, you know, shit like that, we damn near been replaced as an ethnic group in America, because we still call what? A minority here in America. You know why? It's because the white folk can tell us to focus more on immigration than focusing on your own cousins sitting in one of these fucking private prisons around here in America, where they making money off not only him being in there every day, but if you trying to call your relative, you gotta have money on a fucking card just to do that. They charging your relative. At CCC, let me show y'all something. At CCC, Carroll Correctional Center, one package of Roman noodles costs you $1. $1. Your phone call. Man, Steve Prater is making so much money up there at that center, man. It's crazy. And I know he's paying the fire marshal off, because there's no way in the hell you're supposed to have 3 people living in a room that's the size of a bathroom. I go in my brother's bathroom right now and show y'all this little small space, and you'll be surprised that 3 people got to live in that space up to 2, 3, 4, 5 years sometimes, depending on how their charges come out. Man, you think I give a fuck about some illegal immigration when black people are victims of a private prison industry created by people like Bill and Hillary Clinton, created by the Bushes, created by a prison industrial complex that would take money, I mean, take your military, go down to South America, get all that dope, bring it back up here, put it in your community, and then once you go to jail for selling it, they put you in their prisons. This is how deep the game go. And this is what we're going to be doing from now on Real New Behind New. Real short video, letting y'all know how this shit really goes, man. Because we've been blessed throughout the years. Well, since we've been born, Jehovah in heaven ordained it before I was even born, man. I finally admit it. I am somewhat of a leader, but it's not to be like no Martin Luther King. Some of y'all want me to be Martin Luther King. Some of y'all want me to be Malcolm X. I'm finna be Rob Thomas Jr. Fuck all that and just do what God told me to do. Because evidently it's working, because some of y'all still listening. Hey, y'all be blessed, man. Let me cook this up, man. Hold on, show you what I'm finna do right now. It's a bunch of pork. That's one reason why I can't be no Muslim. Because I mean, if a nigga season it and fry it right, I'll eat some pig motherfucking vagina. I'm serious, man. I love pork. So I couldn't be no Muslim. But this one reason why I do what I do is take care of this little big head son of mine. Hold on. Look at him. Hey, get an introduction, Zante. Get an introduction. This is what? Anyway, that's my son, Zante, over there. He trying to hide. He think he the real new behind new junior. I got to go in there and finish twisting his hair. But again, black folk, you got your own kinfolk sitting in prisons right here in Louisiana and won't even write a letter to them. Won't even send them $5 on their books so they can buy a roll of toilet paper. Because believe it or not, in some of these jails in Louisiana, you got to pay for your own toilet paper. You got to pay for everything in this jail. And not only does the inmate have to serve his time and pay a dollar for a pack of Roman noodles, such as up there at Cattle Correctional Center, but they now charging the family to participate in giving emotional, spiritual, and financial support to those inmates. Because if you put money on their books, they gonna take a few dollars of that. You send them, give them money to go to the commissary where they robbing them on the commissary. In order to talk to them, you gotta put money on a phone card. In order to write to them, you gotta make sure they have stamps. These folks capitalizing every way they can, all black folk being locked up in this this private prison industrial complex. But they got Negroes sitting right here talking about a bunch of people who deliberately chose to come across the border illegally. And now they got caught. They sitting in detention centers as if I'm supposed to give a fuck when I did a lot of time in these private prison industries. Because again, you put the dope in my neighborhood and then put me in a situation where I ain't got no choice but to sell it. Most people gonna sell some dope before they see their kids say they hungry. Most people gonna go out and commit a crime to feed themselves or their habits. You putting the habits in the neighborhood, but you're demoralizing the people with this false reality that you got. So y'all, let me go ahead, man, and get this here cooked up. We'll see y'all. Hey, Shreveport Police Department, Officer Scott, man, you still good, man, but you dead wrong yesterday on that one, cuz.